The pack drivers led across the stream and the valley to enter an intersecting ravine. It was narrow, rough sided, and floored, but the trail was good. Presently it opened into a beautiful V shaped gulch, very different from the high walled, shut in canyons. It had a level floor through which a brook flowed, and clumps of spruce and pine, with here and there a giant balsam. Huge patches of wild flowers gave rosy color to the grassy slopes. At the upper end of this gulch, Joan saw a number of widely separated cabins. This place, then, was Cabin Gulch. Upon reaching the first cabin, the cavalcade split up. There were men here who hallowed a welcome. Golden halted with his pack horse. Some of the others rode on. Wood drove other pack animals off to the right, up the gentle slope, and Red Pierce, who was beside Kells, instructed Joan to follow them. They rode up to a bench of straggling spruce trees, in the midst of which stood a large log cabin. It was new, as in fact all the structures in that gulch appeared to be, and none of them had seen a winter. The chinks between the logs were yet open. The cabin was of the rudest make of notched logs, one upon another, and a roof of brush and earth. It was low and flat, but very long, and extending before the whole of it was a porch roof supported by posts. At one end was a corral. There were doors and windows with nothing in them. Upon the front wall, outside, hung saddles and bridles. Joan had a swift, sharp gaze for the men who rose from their lounging to greet the travelers. Jim Cleve was not among them. Her heart left her throat then, and she breathed easier. How could she meet him?